Republican Florida Governor DeSantis, for example, recently lifted all coronavirus restrictions on businesses, allowing bars and restaurants to open at full capacity without a mask mandate. He said they won't be closing anything going forward. Now, what's your response to Governor DeSantis's policy, one, and would you do the same thing in Texas if you could?
New York in particular has led the country in death rate, and I think it had a lot to do with the Democratic governor there, Governor Cuomo, sending people who had COVID into nursing homes. Well, the death rate is three times as high as the death rate in Texas or Florida. I'm sorry?
I'm talking about Florida right now, not New York.
Government policy was different, and the policy made a difference. The government policy was different, and the policy made a difference. The bulletin in a horrific death rate. No, no, I'm saying we should actually listen to sound science and protect people and keep them safe.
Oh, mocking these idiots never gets old. Ted Cruz never looks so confident as he does when he's on the spew, because he knows that these ladies of the night live in a bubble of ignorance and that they'll just repeat whatever they heard last night on Jimmy Kimmel or Colbert. I showed you some highlights, but we'll go over all the hilarious details right after this short capitalism break from one of this channel's amazing sponsors, Noble Gold. You know, if you worked for a company for years before COVID came around and you were let go, you might have left some treasure behind. Your old 401k or IRA could be worth thousands, and it's still working for your old firm, not you. So if you're a bit uncertain about what the future holds right now, you should call the team at Noble Gold at 1-877-646-5347. And if that's not incentive enough, with each qualifying IRA, you'll get a solid silver 5-ounce Apollo 11 coin free. So it's worth jumping on the phone and calling 877-646-5347 now. That's 877-646-5347. 5347.
Republican Florida Governor DeSantis, for example, recently lifted all coronavirus restrictions on businesses, allowing bars and restaurants to open at full capacity without a mask mandate. He said they won't be closing anything going forward. Now, what's your response to Governor DeSantis's policy, one, and would you do the same thing in Texas if you could?
Oh, of course, Joy Behar is super concerned about Florida reopening, and definitely not solely because it's a Republican governor and favorite scapegoat of the DNC media. Yet this same bloated red harpy has nothing but good things to say about the worst example in this country, New York City, led by Democrat Andrew Cuomo and favorite mass media gaslight. I say that because despite having the highest body count in the country per capita, despite the nursing home blunders, despite the rest of the country being infected from people fleeing New York City, despite wrongly freaking out about the need for ventilators, despite all that, we're told Chris Cuomo's doing great. Florida is currently sitting around 13th in the country per capita. I'll let Ted Cruz do the rest.
So, yes, we should reopen. And I actually think if you look at Florida, if you look at Texas, the death rates have been much, much lower there. Then, for example, states like New York, New Jersey, states with Democratic governors, where the death rates have been enormously through the roof. New York in particular has led the country in death rate, and I think it had a lot to do with the Democratic governor there, Governor Cuomo, sending people who had COVID into nursing homes. Well, the death rate is three times as high as the death rate in Texas or Florida. I'm sorry?
I'm talking about Florida right now, not New York. New York got hit very early, and a lot of people were coming in without any kind of sanctions
on it. But the government policy was different, and the policy made a difference. It's the policy of the governors of New York and New Jersey of sending people who were COVID positive into nursing homes was catastrophic, and it resulted in a horrific death rate. No, no, I'm saying we should actually listen to sound science and protect people and keep them safe.
Deflecting? Who's deflecting here? The guy that's pointing out undeniable data, or the hate-filled Democrat Party donating hag who's deflecting from Democrat failures by pointing to Republican states that are doing noticeably better? And again, look, those top states, Democrat run. See Delaware? They're above Florida and Texas? Democrat-run, and home of Joe Biden. I was just there a couple months ago, and the beaches were packed. So yeah, tell me more about how horrible DeSantis is. That's all for this episode, but I wanted to remind you all to join me and the Drone Tech Politics community for tonight's Rumble in the Jungle between President Donald Trump and Lion Joe Biden. We're going to have some drinking games, and prizes will be given away to the most active participants in chat, which, if you're familiar with DLive, will be determined at the end of the stream. You can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. I hope to see you all there.